very important to take into consider, not to be perfect, and but take into consideration the perfection, how to be to improve ourselves, not to be perfect. I am Andreea Puiu. I am from University of Bucharest and also from Pia Brătianu School. And this presentation I made with Nectara Mircioagă, another great teacher. And I want to present you the way we can learn happiness using STEAM activities, and also to see better how happiness is our creation, and how we can invite students to be creators, and how can they bring their ideas, and how they can do, can change the world idea by idea. This pedagogy of happiness wants to bring happiness and of course the science of happiness in school. And we will speak about happy teachers and happy students and happy principals and also happy parents, because it's important to take into account that happiness should be put in a system, and to improve all the parts of the system. We can make classes more attractive, of course, but also we should take into account to be responsible regarding our happiness, and also to transform the lessons into lessons of happiness, using, as I said, the science of happiness. In today's world, it's hard to keep children drawn to lessons, to knowledge, to discovery sometimes, but it's important to focus on the windows we can create, and to make very easy and very smart to use our resources. It's important every time to remember that we are plenty of resources, and to know that we can create solutions, and that we can create something that is valuable and in at the same time unique for us in schools. We know that the concentration mode can hardly exceed 30 minutes, but we can try by focusing on the sense of the activities to make kids to be more involved in the activities, and also the teachers to feel that they are teachers of happiness, and also that we can experience the curriculum of happiness. The pedagogy of happiness is very linked to STEAM activities, because we can develop many ways to explore learning in the happy way. So we can be happy while we do some activities, because happiness, it is said that is a way of traveling and another destination, and putting in the education environment, we should express our happiness while we learn. So it's important to learn in a happy way, and not to consider only the academic results, only the marks. The pedagogy of happiness is an innovative program. I started the research in 2016, and after 6 years, I can say that I saw a lot of results in schools, and I saw that teachers are very open to this idea of the pedagogy of happiness, and also parents put in balance how to add to the academic results also the feel of happiness. And also one of the key questions is how we can be happy learners. It's important to use the principle of happiness in our activities. The program is based on the latest scientific findings, mainly on neuroscience results, and is aimed at parents, children, and teachers, as I said. The pedagogy of happiness shows that things can be viewed from a different angle, from the happiness angle, from the position where it is natural to be knowledgeable when you settle into a change, from how your brain can react to how a special language such as that of happiness can help you. You have the power to choose not to learn disconnected, which is why you propose learning partnerships, connecting in the classroom, starting from what is of interest to us, the teacher and the students. So what the pedagogy of happiness wants is to bring connection between children and teacher inside the classroom, but also to bring parents to school and to give them the sense of belonging to this space, and also to rebuild in a way the relation with school if that was not so good in the past. Also, we talk about the learning partnership because it's important to have in mind that happiness is a game that we can win together. And if we let some students, some teachers behind, we cannot talk about a happy environment in schools. This notion of a happy school, it's important to be explored by teachers. Because we can do this, and it's something that it can be very easy to attain. It's not something idealistic, it's not an illusion, and scientific studies show this idea. Moreover, it is useful to know that we can transform our state, that we are around the resources that we can activate. In education, neurosciences creates opportunity to be in the area of the open mindset. So when we talk about STEAM activities and the pedagogy of happiness, also we speak about the mentality of happiness, how we can make the minds of children, the minds of teachers to be open, to be plenty of ideas connected to the world. At the same time, we understand the role of habits at every moment of the day, and we understand that we invent our own formula for change, just like some researchers of happiness. So it's important that teachers and pupils to feel and to act as researchers of happiness. Because one of the most important signs of the quality of a school is the level of happiness it hosts. Of course, whenever we make an activity, we pay an emotional price, and it's important to know when we choose to do some activities what we pay emotionally for that activities. That's why we should understand how we invest our resources, our scholar resources in happiness in a school. At the level of happiness, it's important to see the naturalness of children to have the initiative, their autonomy, the responsibility they understand they have regarding their own training. The easy way to ask help, the power to say no in a way that does not block but protect. Also, it's important to have a schedule with a lot and also very clear happy habits, and also the ability to share. Because, you know, in schools, when we talk about the mentality of happiness, it's important to have an intelligent trust. And it's important to have healthy relations. And also it's important to know our unique power. And also it's important to use no as in our voice, but also not to be disconnected, not to be isolated from others. First, what does happiness say about STEAM? It's important to understand that happiness can have a voice in a school. And it's important to value this voice and to put the resources in a space that kids can understand that they can do something. They are not just exposed to the environment. They can change the environment. They can be part of the lessons. One of the objects is bringing pedagogy of happiness and science, technology, engineering, arts, mathematics closer together. The key idea is that STEAM can be studied using the principle of happiness. We can learn, teach, evaluate STEAM activities through the lens of happiness. Happy hours is also a special design of classes, respecting, taking into account the scientific directions. And in this moment, we can speak about autonomy learning and personalized projects, about affirmative brain, referring to Daniel Siegel. It's important to speak in school that we create brave, resilient, self-sufficient pupils. It's important to be a reality that we use every day for each moment of a day, the happiness habits during STEAM activities. It's important to use the power of collaboration in these activities. And it's in our power as teachers to go beyond the myth of happiness, as Sonia Lyubomirsky tells in their books, and also to go beyond the myth of learning, because we use sometimes ideas that are not useful or ideas that are not for our present. It's important to take into account when we make these STEAM activities that sometimes technology can have a dark side, and the cyber effect is also a notion that we can explore, because the safety environment for a kid is very important to analyze. A STEAM way to win at the game of happiness can be inside the school. We can learn together, we can win together, and it's important to focus on authentic learning based on curiosity, solution for the real world, and variety in learning design. Also, we should take into account during the STEAM activities the anti-fragility that we can be more powerful when we go beyond the hard times, and also after we try some solutions, we have not to stop if the result is not what we wanted. It's important to create another strategies to be happy in learning. Also, sometimes we want to add a lot of activities. And from the happiness point of perspective, it's important not to do more things, but to do differently the things. And the STEAM activities are the best context to show kids how to simplify, how to use different designs, and to have a different and creative output. One of the main ideas is that we should bring, we should develop the mindset of happiness in schools, starting from flow activities, so activities that are rewarding for us, and during these activities we don't feel that time flies. And also it's important to put in our STEAM activities, our power of creativity, because as one of the happiness researcher from Romania says, the way we become happy depends at the most degree on our creativity. So we can be at our high level of creativity in STEM activities. Also, we should train our brain to create happiness, because happiness is also a habit, is a muscle that can be developed. We should not be afraid, even we have around us, things that can make us be afraid, it's important to have in mind that happiness can happen also in a hostile world. And also to know that if we are happy, we can do good, because if we feel good, we do good. So it's important to invest in the positive relation in school. After understanding very well what happiness is, mainly scientific happiness, beyond the myth of happiness and myth of learning. School happiness can be a priority, maybe not the main priority, but one of the most important things we can have in our view as teachers, as educators, because school happiness is a goal which many educated parents and students share. And also, a happy school offers a healthy environment for learning. All our efforts as teachers, as educators for this mindset of happiness is to bring and to sustain the love of learning, because through the pedagogy of happiness, we can bring happiness in school. I will show you a gallery of happiness in a school to understand better what you can do from this point of mentality of happiness. For example, activities that are linked to the rules, not against rules, but for example, writing on windows at school, it is funny, and also you can practice, as you can see in the photo, the writing. For kids, is like, wow, I can do this at school. Yes, you can do this, but after that you have to clean and so on. So we should focus on logical consequences and to make things, to make kids understand that they can do a lot of things, but in a healthy way and in a way that is useful at school. Also climbing in trees and reading, so to bring nature close to our activities, or using movements during the activities, because movement is for brain, as Medina says, is like a candy, is a cognitive candy for the brain, or writing on the walls poetries, and after that memorizing them in a creative way. Starting from the first day of school with amazing things like huge balloons, and also talking about the formula for these balloons. Also letting kids to transform the schoolyard, or to add their ideas in the school environment, and after that remembering that their hands change the school. Or also we have green hours, green classes at school. We can stay at sun, and also the happiness hormone are very easy to be activated in our body. So it's important to have in mind the happy body and also the happy mind during the STEAM activities. And the last part is about the positive practices in a happy school, because science can be funny, and we can use, regardless the age level, we can use playful activities. We can add mystery parts that things that for kids are very playful, and it's very very easy to them to involve in the activity. Another
Andrea,
example.
You've given us such a wealth of suggestions there. It's been a pleasure hearing your presentation. We're actually running out of time, unfortunately. But you've definitely brought some sunshine into all of our afternoon this afternoon. Wonderful suggestions. And I really like the fact that you highlighted the importance of connecting not only between student and teacher, but also making sure that there is that connection with the parents as well. Mm-hmm. So a wonderful presentation. Thank you so much for sharing
us. I keep an eye on the time. So I had 2 minutes more from what I saw. But thank you, Victoria, for helping me. And I hope you keep in mind that happiness can be learned at school.